Well, welcome to our Ladies Empowerment Call. This is our Tuesday night call, and we're so excited tonight to have all of you that are on the line gather with us. We know that in just a few more moments there will be more that will join us, but for now we want to get started with what we have in store for tonight. And I'm just so happy. I'm so excited to be part of this group of women, this group of phenomenal women that are incredible leaders that have done some amazing things. This group of women that come together to empower each other, to strategize, to teach, and to learn together. This group of wise women. I am just so excited to be connected to the lives of so many that have come on this line and that have shared the stories, have shared their journeys, have unfolded to us the secrets to their successes, and have just been very candid with all of us so that we know as women, and not just women, but men as well, we all know that there is nothing greater than the will to succeed. And if you have that, there will be nothing that will be able to stop you. If you define the purpose that is in your life, there will be nothing less than a guide that will help you walk out and fulfill your destiny and your purpose. And so with that in mind, tonight's call is not unlike any others that we've experienced. And I'm excited tonight about this call because we're going to be hearing tonight for the first time on this line a woman that is just incredible. I had the opportunity to meet her through connecting with her in business. And so we've talked from time to time, and you know, she's just one of the most pleasant people I've ever met. But more than that, she's a professional. In fact, she's an avid professional, someone that absolutely loves the work that she does. She's someone that cares not only about people, but she cares about animals. And so when I tell you there is nothing greater than the heart that I've found to be inside of our speaker tonight, and I'm just so grateful to be able to call her my friend. She's my business partner. She's just a leader within this team, and she's someone that we can all look to for assistance, for help, whenever we need questions answered about anything that has to do with medical science. And I'm speaking of none other than Dr. Karen Kelly from Foley, Alabama, our speaker tonight. Dr. Kelly, I'm just going to toss it right on over to you.
Thank you so much, Gwen. Can you hear me?
I absolutely can.
Excellent. Thank you so much for your kind words. So tonight I'm going to share with all the folks on the Women's Empowerment Call what I call the 80-20% rule in the game of life. You know, about 45 years ago, before I became a physician, I started my career as a social worker, and I realized early on that if I followed this 80-20% rule in all the aspects of my life, that my life ran smoother. And back in the day, when I was a social worker, I worked in the field of juvenile services, and I was one of the social workers that would take these, quote, delinquent kids and disturbed kids with all kind of family issues, and we would take them before the court and before the judge. And if we didn't have all our facts in a row and do our 80% and really understand that family and the dynamics of the family and find the best choices for this child and make those recommendations to the judge, we would be totally caught with egg on our face when we went into court, because we had to face the judge. There were attorneys there and family members and other social workers and other cases, and we'd have to go, "Your Honor, my name is Karen Kelly. I'm the social worker on record for John Doe," and so forth, and present the case to the judge. And if we did our due diligence and we did our 80%, then 9 times out of 10, that judge would take our recommendations. And so that's what I learned very early on along, that we have to do our 80% or things don't run so smoothly. And so this rule really applies to everything in our lives. It applies to buying a car, a house, choosing a doctor or a healthcare practitioner or a college or a company to partner with, or choosing a lifestyle that best fits our needs. And this includes, of course, our food choices, how much sleep and exercise we feel is optimal for us, what types of supplements that we take, what types of skin care and home care products that we use, even the type and the quality of water that we drink. And you know, last night, our beloved founder, co-founder, and president and chief science practice of our company, Sizzle International, gave a wonderful presentation about all the research that he has done on water and his new invention of this high-quality water purification system, and I'm so excited about that because the quality of the water we drink and how much water we drink with so many toxins that are facing us in our environment today is hugely important. So I want to do a shout-out and a thank you for Mr. Tom Maurer Sr. for all the due diligence and his 80% that he has done in the field of water and exploration and science and innovation and all the things he did to bring this technology to the forefront, which is now available to all of us and all the Sizzle customers that would come aboard and take a look at our products. So, for example, this 80-20% rule, let's just say buying a car. But to give you an example, would you just open a magazine and see a pretty car and then say, ooh, that looks good, I think I'll run to my nearest dealer? Go to the nearest dealer, the first car you walk on the floor that looked like the picture, you just go and buy it, sign a contract and go buy it. No questions asked. Probably not. And these days, you'd probably do a whole internet search, you'd do CarMax, you'd ask some friends for advice, you'd select the color and an interior, and you'd shop prices, and you'd choose the best dealership with the best sales staff, and maybe you'd look at the customer service and the auto parts department, and look at the best financing options and the best warranty, and then you check out the safety features and the engine performance. You would test drive it. You might even check with the spouse if that applies to you. And then you decide, you know, what I want to really pay for this car out the door, what I want to pay. I consider that our 80%. And then the 20% is easy. You close the deal, you sign the papers, you drive out with the car, hopefully the car of your dreams, or at least with Sizzle, soon it will be the car of your dreams, and then just enjoy the ride. That's the 80-20%. And if you had not done your 80%, you might have, you know, not gotten the best deal, or you might even have gotten a lemon, or a month down the road, you might have buyer's remorse because the car didn't meet your expectations and it fell short of the experience that you were hoping for. So another very important example of doing our 80% is when choosing a doctor. Many of you know that a part of my email address is health is wealth. And I truly believe that if you have your health, you have wealth. Not only because if you have good health with enough energy and vitality and mental clarity and focus to create the financial wealth for you and your family, but also because health affords you a wealth of opportunities that may not be available to you if you are suffering from health challenges with little energy to spare. So our Sizzle team is called Team Wealthy Place, which I believe refers to being wealthy in terms of our finances and in terms of our health. And when we take a look at the concepts of this health and wealth, we find, again, the 80-20% rule applies. So let me share a few statistics with you. You know, I've always told my friends and my patients, you know, if you get run over by a Mack truck, it's better that you get run over in this country and not in Bangladesh. Why? Because we in the United States have the best emergency trauma medicine in the world. So we can patch up if you're in some deep trouble. But we fall way short in the field of prevention. And as some of you know, I'm also a licensed acupuncturist. And when I was studying Chinese medicine, I learned at that time, this was some years ago, that in China, you only pay your doctor when you're well. So if you're sick, they don't get paid. So clearly, they have an incentive to keep you well. And do you think that if this concept were applied in this country, our medical community might be more interested in the education of their patients in prevention? And did you know that the number one cause of death in this country is doctor error, inpatient and outpatient, in conjunction with prescribed medication? This kills more of us than all the other top three killers, heart disease, cancer, and diabetes. And that's pretty scary. So with this model, we might start to ask, what's wrong with this picture? And you know, as Tom Maurer Sr. said last night on his amazing call, one in every 1.5 people will get cancer in their lifetime. Versus 100 years ago, he said 1 out of 8,000. So we need to turn this system around and be more proactive and take better charge of our lives. So clearly, some of the contributing factors are the high stress levels and the high exposure to toxins, including even toxic thoughts that we are all exposed to on a daily basis from the news, from, you know, people outside, including our own little negative self-talks. So clearly, one of the biggest stressors as well to most folks today is financial stress. So as empowered women, how can we empower ourselves and our families and others to make better choices in the areas of our health and our wealth? So let's take a look at how we can do our 80% in choosing our doctor, our primary health care provider. You know, most people take more time choosing a car than they do choosing a doctor. So here again, an example would be, do you just open the yellow pages, you just close your eyes and point, and then make an appointment with whatever doctor is under your finger? Hopefully not. So you may want to examine things like the doctor's credentials, education, certifications, their training, their reputation, their character. You might want to ask a friend what they might know about him or her, and maybe what type of experience they've had or have heard about. You might want to know where they're located, what are their hours, do they accept Medicare or the insurance covers that you have, or the wait time to get an appointment. Are they trained in nutrition or holistic integrative medicine? Or are they open to referring to other holistic practitioners if need be, and other healthcare providers such as a chiropractor, a licensed massage therapist, an acupuncturist, maybe a cranial sacral therapist, etc. In addition to prescribing medications, are they also open to recommending nutraceuticals? And you know, most conventional medical doctors may not even know the difference between supplements and nutraceuticals. And maybe some people on the call tonight might not know the difference. So let me share that with you. Supplements are substances that may have some health benefits, but don't have any science to back them up and have not been tested for safety, efficacy, and purity. Nutraceuticals, however, are manufactured in a pharmaceutical-grade lab. They're scientifically formulated and tested to be safe and pure and effective, and to actually contain inside the bottle what is written outside the label. Many of us recently have heard in the news and have read about some folks taking different remedies out of certain stores and so forth, certain supplements, and going taking them to a third-party lab. And lo and behold, some of them had zero of the substance that was supposed to be the main ingredient that was written on the label. So we want to be sure that the supplements and nutraceuticals and other products that we're taking actually have in the bottle what's written on the label, and that they're standardized. So if you order something this month and you order the same kind of product 6 months from now, it's going to be the same formulation, it's going to be standard, and you'll know you'll get the same good quality with each batch. All of this is, by the way, one of the many reasons that I chose Sizzle International as a provider for myself and my patients of some of the highest quality products on the market. So then get back to choosing a doctor. So now once we choose a doctor, we've done our 80%, we've taken a look at this, we haven't just point and chosen and made an appointment. So then we show up for our first visit. And what's the next thing? What do we look for? How long did we have to wait in the waiting room before seeing the doctor? How did the staff treat us? Was the doctor kind and caring? Was he or she respectful and knowledgeable and thorough and clear in communicating their findings and the reason for ordering certain tests? Did he or she take time with us? Did they listen? Did they read our intake history and ask pertinent questions? Did he or she or a staff member explain the tests and what to expect? And once a diagnosis was made, did they explain the prognosis and the treatment plan adequately and give us options? And so forth. So in other words, did the doctor do their 80%? Not only to gain our trust and possible referrals in the future, but to provide us with the best possible medical care. And, you know, in my many years of practice, the comment I heard most often from my patients was, "Dr. Kelly, no doctor has ever spent so much time with me and asked the types of questions that you have." And, you know, that's so important because I was trained as a clinical therapist, a social worker. I spent many years as a psychotherapist in private practice. And what I discovered along the way was that nearly every single health challenge that my patients came to me for help with had a trigger of an emotional issue. And I would always ask this question. There were several I asked. I would always say, "What are the top stressors in your life?" You know, after I got all the medical part of the history and everything, what they tried, what worked, what didn't, what doctors they went to, how it was helpful, and so forth, I would say, "What are the five stressors?" And, you know, often top stressor was finances. And often health, you know, being ill was up there. And then relationships, usually whatever they were partnered with or maybe a boss or, you know, and then was job. You know, people tend to be in jobs that they don't love. And, you know, you've heard the phrase, "Do what you love and the money will come." Well, most people are in jobs, and we've all heard the little acronym, job means just over broke, and there's just not enough money at the end of the month to you know, have any fun, to have some downtime, to enjoy life, to nurture and buy ourselves something special. So those are some of the things that we look at. And then inevitably, because of my psychotherapy training, I would ask the question, what was going on in your life maybe 6 months, maybe even a year, before you had this health challenge appear, no matter what the health challenge was? And I can guarantee you they would say a divorce or a financial a crisis or a death in the family or something like that, a hurricane or something like that. There was always an emotional trigger that somehow was at the root of their health challenge developing. And so I made it my focus to do my 80%. And while I was treating them with the protocols and so forth and the nutritional supplements and the cranial sacral work or whatever I was doing to doctor them and on their health journey, I would always offer them an opportunity, because I was a licensed psychotherapist as well, to talk about these issues. And I'm writing a book right now, and it's called A Time to Heal, A Vision of Love, Healing Your Relationship with Your Sacred Self. And in that, one of the chapter is called Getting Rid of the Issues in the Tissues. And it's a phrase that I coined because if we don't get those emotional issues out, all of those old patterns that aren't serving us, all the things that we believed that we were taught as kids that may not really be in alignment with our highest purpose and our highest selves, but we're still living as if you're not good enough, you'll never amount to anything, you can't do this, you know, girls can't be doctors, but you can be a social worker, you can be a teacher, you know, but if you want to be an Olympic athlete, well, I don't know. And see, that was my generation. Now guess what? More vets are girls, more doctors are women, more, you know, more athletes are coming up that are women. But in my generation, a girl was a girl, and we didn't get to do good stuff like boys got to do. So now that has changed. So having said that about how we ask questions and what questions we ask, no matter what we're doing, do the 80% and the 20% will be gravy. It will be so much easier. So, you know, one of the things that I was doing was not only the extensive medical history, but, you know, the exam, the asking the stressors, all of the things that I said, developing a wonderful treatment plan, talking it over, getting, you know, one question I would always ask my patients was, and you might think this is odd because they come to me to figure that out, but I say, what do you think is wrong with you? What do you think is going on? And guess what? They may not know all the big names and whatnot, but if you listen, and in anything, whether you're sharing these products, whether you're sharing the sizzle opportunity, whether you're sharing a story in your life, If you listen to the response and the feedback you get from the person you're talking with and you be a good listener, you will be amazed at what they will tell you. So they will tell you things, and it's almost as if they diagnose themselves and very accurately, because guess what? They're living in their body. If they, you know, I always tell them first when they come to me, I'm not the healer, you're the healer, I'm the health coach. If you cut yourself, your body heals that. I don't heal that. Your body heals that so you don't bleed to death. You're the healer. I'm just going to give you the tools. So that's important. And how did I do my 80% to get there? You know, how many gazillion years of school and all the other courses we take, just like educating yourself on the business that you're doing or anything else that you want to do. That's your 80%. So when you do all of that, and you educate your patients, and you know the word doctor in Greek means teacher, and you've heard the phrase, you can give a man a fish and he eats for today, but you can teach a man to fish and he eats for a lifetime. So no more of this, okay, Sue, take two aspirin and call me in the morning. You know, that don't quite cut it. And, you know, like they say, an apple a day doesn't cut it anymore. It's not quite there. It's a little bit different. What we want to do to truly take the time to listen to people and to educate them, no matter what field you're in, listen and then educate. Give people better choices based on your knowledge and your experience, and that's what you want to share with them. So if I did all that with my patients, then the 20% that was left would result in the best outcomes, and it was relatively easy to follow. And then they had to do their 80%. They had to do their due diligence, drink more water, get plenty of rest, and so forth. So my point is, if doctors would do their 80% up front, there may be less of this medical error that seems to be the number one cause of death in this country. There'd be more diverse and integrative medical options in our treatment plans, and better outcomes in achieving more optimal states of health, and quicker recovery times for their patients. So that's all fine and good because I'm a physician, but how does this apply to choosing, for instance, a company to partner with? Our 80% in choosing a company, which hopefully most of us on this call either are doing now as we speak or have already done. And so the 80% is checking out these aspects before you choose to partner with a company such as Sizzle. Is the company stable? Does it have longevity? Sizzle is, in fact, a debt-free 9-year-old company that is here to stay. Is their mission in alignment with our goals and values? Sizzle's motto is people and products over profit. And their global mission is to provide toxin-free, safe, effective, high-quality products for everyone globally. I think this is a mission that we can all wrap our hearts around. Do they have good leadership? Are the founders and directors and CEOs and managers and supportive staff of the company accessible and transparent and integrative? Are they of good ethical and moral character? Do they have leadership skills? Are they open to ideas and suggestions from the field? We certainly have found this to be true with Sizzle. Is the infrastructure solid and in place to help the company run smoothly and efficiently? And even though in every company, no matter where they are in their growth, it's always a work in progress, they're always making improvements, I can say a resounding yes to this with Sizzle. Are the products toxin-free and of the highest quality? And diverse enough to fit the needs of everyone? And you know, with Sizzle, we have over 200 products to choose from. And so, and they're all toxin-free. And they're made with the highest synergistic formulation so that they're the most effective that we can find in the industry. Is the website easy to navigate and efficient with back office capabilities? And you know, this is another thing. Sizzle is working and upgrading every day on making our website even more beautiful and more navigatable than it already is, which it's already awesome. And are there training opportunities? Absolutely. Our Team Wealthy Place even is putting wonderful training opportunities. We have weekly training calls and opportunity calls, and there are more things coming down the pipe with Sizzle. So the training is already wonderful and going to be even more so. Is our customer service department knowledgeable, patient, clear, helpful, courteous, and quick to respond to our calls? This is a resounding yes. Before I partnered with this company, I purposely called the customer service department 6 different times at different times of day to see how was the wait time before they responded. Did they have all of these qualities that I just mentioned? And I was absolutely astounded that this was truly one of the most efficient and effective customer service department of any company I've ever been with. And also, we want to do our 80%. How is their compensation plan structured? Do they pay the distributors well and on time? And you know, Sizzle has one of the most robust comp plans that I believe is unprecedented in the history. They pay us daily on 7 levels on our fast start bonus with a 60% payout to the field, and I've always been paid on time, and they pay us very well with many other bonuses and so forth, even a car bonus that is extremely easy to achieve. And most importantly, for those of us who decide to share the products and build a successful business, what is the caliber of the upline support team? And you know, with Team Wealthy Place, our leaders and our support and my beloved mentor in this business, Carl Trautner, is always there. He answers the phone every time, and he's always supportive and helpful. And the same for Jerome and Gwen and Dr. Michelle and so many of the people I can reach out, and the support is there. And this is what makes so many people who get involved in a word-of-mouth relationship industry in a business, they fall short because they're not getting the support. This is absolutely outstanding with our Team Wealthy Place. And so, you know, before we joined, you know, you do your 80%. And then the 20% that follows of changing lives worldwide, both in health and wealth, will flow with much more ease and much more successful outcomes. So finally, let us carry this 80-20% rule to the choices we make in our health and personal growth. As empowered women, in order to attain and maintain optimal health while growing personally and spiritually, our 80% might include some of the following. Finding spiritual, motivational mentors and teachers and healthcare professionals along the way. Taking charge of our lives by being more proactive in our own health choices. You know, it's one thing to get sick or not feel good and go to a doctor and let them tell you what to do. But it's another thing, as we said, spending a little more time in prevention and then taking charge, even getting a second opinion if we need to. So we want to make better choices in the amount of sleep we get and the type of water and how much water we drink and the types of foods we ingest and even our relationship choices. And how about how we spend our time? Do we carve out time for fun? Do we balance work and play and prayer time or meditation time or just our spiritual reading time? Are we spending any time healing our relationships with money or other old patterns that may no longer serve us? These are important. And also, our 80% is choosing the nutraceuticals and the cosmetics and the skincare and the home care products we choose that are toxin-free and healthy for ourselves and our family, which Sizzle is exquisite in providing. And also, embracing an attitude of gratitude. Focusing on what we choose to experience rather than what may be lacking in our lives. You've always heard, what you focus on is what you create. And so many people are financially stressed, so they're focusing on what they lack instead of being grateful for what they have and building on that and moving forward. And also, our 80% is, you know, setting life goals, including daily and weekly and monthly goals. What is our mission statement? Some of the people on this call have written mission statements. Some of us read them every day so we can stay focused. I bought a Cancun t-shirt, and I found a little frame that had shells, and it said Cancun, so I can take a picture of myself in Cancun, Mexico, when I earn that trip. And I've got stuff plastered all over the house. Karen Kelly wins the Cancun trip, you know, November, whatever, and so forth. And so what you look at every day and what you focus on is eventually what comes to pass. So setting these goals, and then finding a support group or a mentor or a friend to hold us accountable. Did you make those three calls? You know, did you sample some of the coffee or the tea? And that's another part of the 80%. I've tried to teach people that want to do the business. Now, if you hand out the coffee and you don't have a little sticker or you staple it to one of your cards of how they can get in touch with you with a little website and so forth, you know, it's kind of a lost leader. And if you forget to get their name and their phone number and, if possible, their email address, you've lost that lead. So that's your 80%. So it's great to sample things, but you got to do the other, or you'll just lose the other end of that, which is a person coming back saying, I love the coffee, and I want to buy a box, or I want to be a customer, or I want to do the business. And the next thing to look at in our 80% is familiarizing ourselves with all aspects of our sizzle business and getting the training available so that we can most effectively and efficiently share the products and the business opportunity with others. So if they ask us a question, we're not kind of stumbling. We either know where to find it online or we have more knowledge about it. And also to learn for ourselves, and it'll be different for each person, what does it take to be a go-giver and not just a go-getter towards being of the highest service to others and making a positive difference in the lives of others? This is important. One of the best books I've ever read that I've given to so many people is exactly, the title is Go Giver by Bob Burg, B-U-R-G. And the whole principle of this book is if you give greater value and greater service to others than what they expect, you will have a customer for life. You will have a friend for life forever. And I think that's important. And then the other 80%, by nurturing and appreciating and honoring and respecting ourselves and letting go of any negative self-talk that may serve to pull us down and distract us from our true purpose. That's so important. And finally, by doing something every day that awakens our hearts to who we truly are, always choosing to do that which is in alignment with our highest and best and most authentic self. So, if we follow the 80% steps in our daily life and in the choices we make, then the 20% will easily follow, which may look like more success, more happiness and joy, a sense of inner peace, more balanced relationships, more financial freedom, and, you know, just plain more love and laughter and fun along the way. And who couldn't use more of that? So I just want to say to everybody on the call, God bless, and may everyone on this call have an amazing 80-20% magnificent week.
Well, thank you so very much for that, Dr. Karen Kelly. Wow, what an amazing presentation, and I knew it would be because I know you are a phenomenal woman. And, you know, as we listen tonight, those of you that are on this line, you've heard from a professional, someone that's not just speaking, you know, based on what feels or sounds good, but she's speaking truly not only from her heart, but from her expertise, from her information, her education. And these things are true, so very true. You know, Dr. Kelly, if I were to ask you just one question tonight, what motivated you to want to even go into the field of medicine in the first place? From, you know, being a child, probably a young girl. Thank you so much also for speaking to the diversity of the ability of girls. You know, if we don't limit girls, you know, allow them to have the choices that they want to make, to be given a chance to, you know, do things like pursue their education and become professionals. So what motivated you to want to become a doctor?
Well, you know, I can remember at a very early age, I was always taking care of the little kids and, you know, fixing their little bruises and whatever. And I was kind of the protector of the littler kids. And I always had a heart for animals. And my parents probably didn't know what to do with me and wondered, who is this child? I would bring wounded birds and toads and rabbits and little nieces and snakes and, you know, whatever into the house. And I would try to fix them, you know. And I guess I just, you know, was kind of a born healer from when I was a kid. When I got a little older, I would hold up my hands and I'd say to my dad and my mom, you know, what kind of hands are these? And, you know, they would clearly say, well, teacher, you know, a musician. And I was taking piano lessons at the time. I'd say, these are doctor's hands. And I said that probably weekly from the time I was 8 years old. And I knew that I always wanted to be a doctor. And one of the reasons I entered social work school first was because I realized from my experience with many conventional medical doctors, at least at that time, they didn't have the connection or the skills with really listening and really asking the questions and dealing with the person's emotional health. It was always kind of the physical health. And I knew that if I was a social worker and really had good listening skills and worked with people on that level and had my psychotherapy private practice, that it would make me a better physician. So I didn't just choose social work first and then, you know, go to medical school as an afterthought. And I remember when I was interviewing for social work school, they asked me, well, now, why do you want to be a social worker? And I says, oh, because I'm going to, you know, apply for medical school. And they go, well, wait a minute. If you're doing that, why are you doing this? And I says, because, in just what I said, I think it will make me a better doctor. So that's kind of what drew me. I'm really focused on, you know, changing lives and making a difference. And, you know, in my Native American ancestry, it was always a phrase of ours. Always make the choices today that will help 7 generations later. That whatever you do today, be sure it endears the fact that we have 7 generations that are coming after. So don't cut down all the trees and pollute all the water and kill all the fish and, you know, do all, you know, strip mine. Be sure you leave enough for 7 generations. So, you know, I want to leave a 100-year legacy at least, and have as my mission to help change lives.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for sharing tonight again. Thank you for fulfilling your dream because you've done that. So many people have been able to benefit from you making that commitment to go after what you dreamed about and just what's been in you probably all of your life. You know, tonight you shared so richly about the 80-20% rule, making the best decision, you know, doing our 80%, you said, which is really our due diligence, you know.
Exactly.
That rule applies to everything, every single thing in our life. Every decision we make in life literally affects the way that we're going to live out our lives for the rest of our lives and the quality of life that we're going to have. You know, you said that if the 80% is done right, then the 20% is key because that's the part where you get to reap the benefit of doing the work. And the key thing there is we've got to do the work because you just said something else. If you flip that around, if you flip it, a rule of thumb really would state that 80% of the outcomes that we're having, you know, in our health, in our wealth, you know, our future generations, 80% of those outcomes can probably be attributed to 20% of the actions that we take. So it doesn't take a lot for us to have to do the right thing in order to affect something so much greater in the future. So the question tonight, you know, as we've all listened to Dr. Karen Kelly share her vision, share her journey, just share her passion over the work that she's doing is we have to ask ourselves, are we doing the work? Are we, you know, doing our due diligence? Are we following up? You know, every one of us has an endeavor. Are we following up? You know, in our business, we always speak about the fortune is in the follow-up. And so, you know, as we've listened tonight, I thought back on when I was you know, early on in my health career, I was a health educator, and I used to actually teach a course called How to Be a Better Health Consumer. And Dr. Kelly, we would start that out by just talking about what is the definition of good health. And you know, the World Health Organization says that good health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being. It's not just the absence of disease. And so tonight, as you share with us, you know, especially women, we're exposed to so much. And Dr. Kelly, thank you for helping us understand how important it is to identify and avoid unethical practices and, to really focus on how to find a provider. What are the qualities we should be looking for? And then you talked a lot about prevention. Prevention, oh my goodness, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. That's still true. That is so true. And so I just want to thank you for sharing with us tonight. I want to say before we close out, one of the most important things I heard Dr. Kelly say was that we should have an attitude of gratitude. We should be grateful for whatever we have. You know, we should set our goals, and then we should speak. We should only look, and we should only focus on those things that we want to see come to pass. And, you know, with that said, I mean, there's not much more that can really be said. Tonight, Dr. Kelly, thank you so much. Oh, and I want to mention that you shared a lot about the company that most of us represent, Sizzle. That's a company that stands for Science, Innovation, Success, Energy, and Longevity. To get more information about Sizzle, I want to invite you, if you're on the call, to get back to the person who invited you to the call tonight, and they can share more information about Sizzle. But if you're on this line tonight, we just thank you so much for being part of this weekly call. This is our Ladies Empowerment Call, and we want to also invite you to go like us on Facebook. We are at facebook.com/Team Wealthy Place. And in closing, I want to thank my co-host. She is on the line. She's silent on the line tonight, but thank you so much for this opportunity tonight, Dr. Michelle Knight. And also, again, want to thank Katrina Greenhill, who is manning our operation in the background. She's facilitating our recording platform. So thank you so much. And again, all of you, we bid you all a great evening. Thank you so much for being on the call. Again, get back to the person that invited you to the call for more information. And in closing, I want to say, be a go-giver, not just a go-getter. Our call is officially over. God bless.